got these from Farmfoods. They were £1 each. This is the full range. And when I first saw them, I thought, ooh, these look absolutely disgusting. I thought, that is just so disgusting. Mixing two different meals together like that is absolutely rank. Well, that's the oven warming up. I'm going to do them in the oven. I'm going to give them the best opportunity possible. It's mac and cheese chili beef. Oh, beef chili. Don't want to get it the wrong way around. Oh, my word. Then it's mac and cheese BBQ beef. Then it's mac and cheese chicken fajita. Now, I've left a long enough pause there for people to say, actually, you think I'll find it's pronounced fajita? Yeah, well, I'm English and I pronounce a J as a J. All right. Just like I would Josie for Jose. There's pictures at the end so you can see what's in them and what is not in them. Now, I already know what they sort of look like inside the box because my nephew has already eaten one of these and I had to repurchase it. And he tried this beef chilli one, I believe he got, and he said it was alright. But I'm going to try them for myself because I just think it's so disgusting. I mean, I cannot decide what meal to have, but they decide to have both. Anyway, this is mix up exclamation mark. Cooked chicken breast strips, yellow and red peppers, onions in a smoky tomato sauce with cooked macaroni pasta in a cheese sauce topped with jalapenos. That is the mac and cheese chicken fajita. Oh, that is just vile, isn't it? Look at that. Anyway, oh, sorry, headphone wearers, I didn't think it'd be that loud. Beef in a smoky tomato sauce again with cooked macaroni pasta and a cheese sauce topped with red Leicester cheese and breadcrumbs. Oh, the compartments are different, aren't they? One's bigger than the other. Minced beef, red kidney beans and red and green peppers topped with jalapenos in a spiced tomato sauce with cooked macaroni pasta in a cheese sauce. This one, it looks like, why has this one got spots and the other one hasn't? That's confusing. There is pictures at the end so you can see what's in them and what is not in them. I need to kill this, don't I? Stabby, stabby! There we are, done! I don't know how to work my mum's oven. Mum! Can you set the timer on the oven for 40 minutes for me, please? Yeah. You're still on camera.
Oh, okay. 40 minutes?
40 minutes, yeah.
Okie dokie, my love.
Lovely. Thank you very much. Peel back film lid. Carefully stir both compartments, recover and return to the oven. How many out of these three do you think are going to actually peel back? Right, we'll have to get a fork in there and give them a mix, aren't I? It's a good job this one's got the spots on because then I can roughly remember which order there was. Now I've got to stir each of these. Don't do what I'm doing. Remember, asbestos fingers. I've got to... Ooh, look at this. It's peeling. It peeled. Flipping it. Give it a mix. Give it a mix. I'm going to have to use separate forks, aren't I? Give it a bit of a mix. That like that. Like that. Good, 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 good. I'm going to have to use separate forks. Things though, I'm at my mum and my dad's house. I'm going to be using that. I don't have a dishwasher here. Oh! Mum, I wish you had a dishwasher. She said tough. Give that in a bit of a mix. There we go. That's got a bit of a mix. It looks as if it's cooking well, which is great. And I'll just give this one a mix. So that is mixed. It smells all right. Here we are. It's giving a bit of a mix. Looks a bit watery, this one, actually. I'm actually salivating. It smells quite good. I think ready meals like this are better if you've got some wraps. Because ready meals these days are so small, I've run out of forks. I had to use a spoon. These are all the same, aren't they? This is just fajita. Mac and cheese. Is it going to undo? It did undo. So I've got to give that a bit of a mix. Yeah, you see, it never does well in the oven, does it? Pasta. I've given that a mix. Stir and recover and return back to the oven. You're watching internationally. For freezer food shops, I think number one is clearly Iceland. Number two, I would say, is Farmfoods. And then number three, you've got Heron. And then number 5972, you've got Jack Fulton Foods. Here we go, we're beeping. Let's see what these look like. Right. Alright, Zanussi. I get it. Middle button, yeah. So weird, isn't it, cooking at somebody else's house? You don't know how to operate any other stuff. Big woof of heat there. Oh, it smells gorgeous, and it's a bubbling and a hissing. So that means I know it's cooked. Woof, it's hot. A big woof of smell. A big woof of heat. Asbestos fingers. Don't do what I'm doing. I don't know how many times you have to tell you not to do, but you've got to be careful. Woof, steam. From the steamed clams we're having. Every time I hear the word steam now, I've got to say it exactly like that. Yeah, this is all like hundreds of degrees hot. So I'm actually salivating. This actually looks quite nice. See, look, pasta never does right in the oven. Look at these dried bits I've got around the edges. You know, it's not good. Right, now to call this off, and I've forgotten which one's which, but it should be fairly easy to know. This is clearly the chicken one. And this is the two beef ones. There we are. Good, good, good. Is that on camera now? That's better. I've got no time to keep pressing buttons on and off on the camera. Right, I want to have a scoop of this. That's not very much. Look at that. This is going to be so much better in a wrap rather than eating it as a ready meal, I think. So there is a spoon of that. I am actually going to have to press pause because this is going to be quite involved. Hang on a sec. A spoonful from each, and I washed the spoon down because I didn't want any flavour transfer. I want editing all that out and together because that'll just suck forever. And then I've took all of this one out because these are all identical. You get about 3 bits of chicken in there. The beef is practically invisible amongst this. It is only £1 each. But looking at it, you don't get very much at all. There it is on the plate. You get about 2 serving spoonfuls of whatever it is, and then you get about 3 of this. This is where the money is saved. Obviously, they give you the most of that. I'm gonna let this cool a bit before I shove it in my face, and we'll see what it's like. This is the best I can do with the lighting, and where we are for the taste test. Now, it's called mix up, exclamation mark, but it's not really a mix-up because you've got to like macaroni cheese done in the microwave or in the oven. You're not really mixing anything up. The serving suggestion is a serving suggestion, yeah. It suggests you serve it on a plate. I've done a whole series on serving suggestions, which I keep meaning to do. But serving suggestion on a plate. I think they've chucked on some Parmesan on that, I think. Enough yakety yak, you want to know how it tastes. Going for the macaroni cheese first. The macaroni cheese, it's got a bit of a peppery tang to it. It's got a bit of a spicy kick to it. That's different. It's actually quite nice. It would have been nice instead of making this mix up range if they're putting some vegetables to roast or something. Made it into an oven version only, might have been nice. It does take 40 to 45 minutes to cook though in the oven. It's too long. If you're going to do it in the microwave, the mind boggles, but I'm sure I could think of better ways to do this. Let's try the chicken one. It's still a bit hot. And it's going to be hot spicy wise. My nephew said he's tried the chicken one and it was quite spicy. It is. Instantly. It's fun. It's nice, but it's something that you'd want to put in a wrap. All the stuff here is all stuff that would have been better in a wrap. They could have put in a couple of wraps and said, remove the wraps, microwave or oven the main things, and then just toast the wraps or something. Mixing it with the macaroni. That was actually really nice. So far, I am wrong. It did look disgusting though, in the picture. When I first saw it, I thought, What sort of bloater? I can't decide what they want, so they have all of it instead. That's what I thought. Let's try the chilli beef. I'm starting to sweat a bit now, and that's not under the weight of the camera like I normally do, but it's very spicy. Ooh, I think you saw from a facial reaction there. That is very good. This is gorgeous, actually. That barbecue beef is, it's a sweet barbecue. My long-term viewers and subscribers will know, me and barbecue sauce are not the best of friends because it's either sweet or smoky or peppery or beefy even. It can be anything. But this is like a sweet barbecue. That is really nice. Mmm. Oh, I like that. Let's try it with the macaroni cheese. And that's, I think it's going to ruin it, to be honest with you. Yeah, don't eat it with the macaroni cheese. When it, ironically enough. Mmm. That barbecue sauce is absolutely delicious. Barbecue beef, amazing. Let's try the chili beef. This is looking really spicy, isn't it? It's going to be as spicy as the chicken one. I'm sweating now. Can you see? Look at that. I'm glistening. I've got swirkles. The chili beef. Yeah, it's got a kick to it. And it's spicy like the chicken one was. Except it's just with beef instead of chicken. You get the consistency, the texture of beef, but you don't really know you're eating beef because it's obviously it's a very cheap meal. But that chili beef just tastes like every standard chili beef I've ever tasted. The barbecue beef, absolutely amazing. Then it's the chicken one, and that's just like every other. And this is, it's all right. It's got a bit of a kick to it in the sauce, and maybe that's a bit unnecessary. I think that's what's ruining it for the sweet one, actually. So there's a bit of chicken. There's a bit of sweet barbecue. Because it is a sweet barbecue. Not that it's totally that on the packaging. And a bit of the, what's it called? Beef chilli. And a bit of that. The sweet one stands out. And then you get the bairn. Very pleasantly surprised with it all in general. I thought it was going to taste a bit bland and flavourless. Oh, I'm sweating like anything here. And that is because of these two. That's my review. Thanks for watching. Do I recommend all of them? Do you know what? I actually would. It's just a shame they're not very well presented. It just makes me feel a bit sick seeing two meals piled high like that. I mean, how small is that plate to fill a plate, look? I mean, I think this is a pretty standard plate. And there's no way with that. And there's about three bits of chicken in mine, and there's clearly more chicken on this. And my nephew said there was about three pieces of chicken in his as well. And on there, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'd say there's less than half the amount of chicken on there. That's my review. Enough yakety yak. Here's the pictures at the end so you can see what's in them and what's not in them. Bye!